hiding in his shadow for a while. To the heart I refuge, my rock in whom I trust, and I will praise you upon eagle's wings, bear you on a breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The fowler will never can fast. As your shield, and I raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the path of dawn, make you like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. Angels will remember you and all of your ways. Upon their hands they bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone, and he raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. Hold you in the palm of his hand.
Again, now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and that fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Again, it was in the waters of baptism that Bill died with Christ and rose with him to new life. Again, may he now share with his Lord in that everlasting glory. Again, we sprinkle him with that holy water, his baptismal water that recalls his baptism as he was baptized into Christ's death. May he now share in his Lord's resurrection. And let us pray. Almighty God, it is our faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was also raised. He is the first fruits of all those who have fallen asleep. Grant through that this mystery, your servant William, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may now share in that joy of his resurrection. Again, we offer this prayer through Christ our Lord. I'd like to share with you the readings that the family has chosen for Bill today. The first one's from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything. There's a time to plant, a time to give birth, a time to die, a time to uproot that plant, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces, a time to seek, a time to lose, a time to keep, a time to cast away, a time to rend, a time to sow, a time to be silent, a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. God has made everything appropriate to its time, but has put the timeless into our hearts so that we cannot find out, or they cannot find out from beginning to end, the work which God has done. Again, the word of the Lord. And our second reading from the New Testament, from the letter of Paul to the Romans. If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. So who will condemn us? It is Christ Jesus who died, rather was raised, who is also at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress, persecution or famine, nakedness or peril, or the sword? No, in all these things, we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, not present things, not future things, not powers, not height nor depth, not any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Again, the word of the Lord. And our final reading today is from the Gospel of Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up a mountain. And after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. And so he began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. And blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. And blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of slander against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." Again, the Gospel of the Lord. You know, one of the things I always like to do is take a look, as I have said before, at a person's name and see how they live the name that they were given. If you look up the name Bill or William, you will see that, at least in my book, you know, what's in a person's name. The name William or Bill means great protector. How perfect for Bill. That's what he was. He was our protector. You know, be it as a family, he was there to protect you. You know, as our country, he served our country to protect us. He always sought to be there to help others. You know, he was that person that was a protector. And I think, you know, how great that was, because in a sense, even the church, he was a protector. I know when I met Bill at St. Patrick's in Shieldsville, Minnesota, you know, the old St. Patrick's, if I may say so kindly, was hit by lightning. And so we had to build a new one, a better one, one that actually had bathrooms, one that had everything we've never had before. God is so good. It was Bill who came forward and said, I want to help you make sure that church is perfect. He became our overseer. Bill came almost every day when that new church was being built. He volunteered to come and to help and to make sure that it was done correctly. I'm not sure if Metcon really liked him there all the time.
They did.
Huh?
They did.
But he was there to protect us, to make sure this new church was being built for St. Patrick's would be the best. And it was. It was wonderful to have somebody like Bill there to protect and to watch over us. And that is something, you know, he's handed on now to his family and to all of us. You know, we are all protectors. In fact, I know he's handed on to Mike. Yeah, you became sheriff. You're a protector. I like your first name, Michael. Who's Michael? The archangel. He's there to protect us. He's handed that on, and I want to thank all our law enforcement, our deputies here today. Thank you for your protection. That's a gift. You know how much we need that protection in that family. That's something that has been handed on to us, and Bill gave that to us, that idea of being caring about others. That's what it was about. And our readings today are about the same thing. I love the Beatitudes. The Beatitudes tell us that it's what we do that's important. I don't know if you ever noticed, don't get me wrong, but the commandments never promise you anything. All those do nots. But every one of the Beatitudes, the do's, promise you something. They promise you, if you mourn, you'll be comforted. If you're a peacemaker, you will do this. If you share in goodness, you will get this. Every beatitude, every time you do something for somebody, you receive in return. The Beatitudes are beautiful examples of when we give, we also receive. All the time, we shouldn't just worry about what not to do, but worry about what we can do for others. And that's what Bill did. He always worried about what he can do for others. That's why he helped his family. That's why he helped his country. That's why he helped St. Patrick's. He wanted to be involved and to share. And that's what he's handed on to all of us, to make sure we want to be active, to care about, and to be with people. Again, what a beautiful thought. Someone who cares about others, wants to be active, wants to get out there and do something. So let's take on that spirit of protection, of caring, and let us go on. It's kind of fun to look at you all watching those things. But anyway, we need to remember that, huh? He cared about family. He cared about community. He cared about his church and his faith. May we also do the same. This time too, is there someone else who'd like to share along with me a little story? Please come forward.
This is a tribute that was written by Mike. On Monday morning at 6:45 a.m., I held on to my dad and watched him take his last breath. His hard-fought battle with brain cancer had come to an end. The heartache of it was watching a strong man dwindle away because an illness was over. But after the heartbreak of losing my dad, after that, the heartache of losing my dad began. My children, grandchildren, entire family lost a guy who always made everyone feel smile, everyone smile and feel loved. I was honored that I had the opportunity to help care for my father. on hospice at the end of November. As the duties and challenges became harder, our family became closer. I find myself thinking about our life and time we spent together, and it brings happiness to my heart. I always felt like my dad and I had a unique connection where we would think or say something on occasion. This is because became more true after his illness and communicating became more difficult. He would either give me a look or make a gesture with his finger, and I knew exactly what he needed. The hardest part now lies ahead for me is that I will no longer be able to ask him how to fix something or figure out an electrical issue. I will miss having him as a fishing buddy and a hunting partner. Hopefully I paid good enough attention to his lessons and advice. One thing I do know, and I try to follow, is that he taught me how to be a good person, husband, father, grandfather, and friend. I want to thank everyone for the messages and condolences and support shown towards my family and I. We truly appreciate it and will help us fill the void. And now that we now miss with Dad gone, thank you.
Trust in God, we pray together for Bill. Indeed, there is sadness in parting like today, but we take comfort and hope that one day we shall see him again and enjoy his friendship. Again, though we will disperse in sorrow, it is the mercy of God that will gather us together in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us always console one another in our faith in Jesus Christ. But when we all just join together in our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. So. I will follow thee. I will bring you home. I love you and you are
brief stories, if I might. The man in the mic, the back said, hold the mic up, okay. A couple of brief stories. I could go on for quite a while, but I will not. Already? Am I cut off? They're brutal. When we walked in, we saw this information about Bill and his service. Service to everybody, 4-H, EMT, he was an electrical contractor, served people, went out the middle of the night to fix their corn dryers, service to the Ronald McDonald House. And I just like to tell you about a story that kind of typifies what Bill was about as a kid. We had a priest uncle who really took care of us. My mom was single mom, dad was around, but at any rate, Uncle Don would come over every Sunday to our house. Mom would cook him a meal, Uncle Don. We didn't call him Father Gormley, we called him Uncle Don. And he would say to us mid-afternoon, say to the three boys, would you wash my car? Oh, we'd all say, yeah, we'll wash your car. Well, Bill was first out there. Now at the end, Rich and I got to split the $2. Bill never got a dollar for washing the car, but he always managed to get the keys so that he could move it from the back of the house to the front of the house and then move it around. That was his payoff. So, and you gotta remember, I'm 10, so he's 12, moving the cars around, and so that was his payoff, but service. He loved it. He could not do enough for people, and you all know that. Rich, the brother in California, did not come for the funeral. He was here for 2 weeks in October when the right time to see Bill. But he wrote a note to all of us. Many of you saw it, but many of you didn't see it. And it said, pray for Bill on his journey to heaven. And help him get there quickly. Get there quickly. But if he shows up late, it's because he stopped to help some other soul who needed it worse than he did. So very, very typical. Now I need my phone because there's actually something in there that I'd like to read. Not notes. Of course, they shut it off. By the way, Father, thanks for being here. I did not introduce you. This is Father George. Was that Shieldsville? Are you retired now?
I'm retired. Yeah.
Okay. Now, wait for the phone to come on. It didn't come on. My daughter lives in Minneapolis, and she is married to a guy whose sister wanted to know what they were going to do last night. And Chris told his sister they were coming to the funeral of Bill Gormley. Bill Gormley. I know that name. Well, of course, it's my brother, but she did not know, and she had a son who was at the Ronald McDonald House many times. Ronald McDonald houses all over the world. He had cancer. Zach did pass from the cancer, but she wrote this beautiful note, which is in my phone, about thanking Bill for being there, providing meals, providing food, providing shelter for not only Zach, but kids all over the world. And that was Bill. Excuse me, I'm looking at a note because I forgot. Bill was an electrician. Now, a lot of you wouldn't know this, but he didn't do real well academically. In fact, we always laughed about it. We said, Bill couldn't spell cat if you gave him the C and the T. But Bill never read an instruction in his life. He could look at something, he knew how it went together, he knew how it came apart. Now, he didn't always get it back together again, as some of us know. But he didn't have to read. He could intuit mechanical stuff. Father knows that. By that time, he could read blueprints. I still can't. I was a builder. But Bill was able to do things that you just couldn't imagine. Now, he graduated from Dunwoody, which takes some academic and some mechanical skills. But I have to tell you that he graduated from Dunwoody without being able to spell cat. Well, he probably could handle cats. But Bill always knew how to skin a cat in a lot of different ways.
Literally.
Bill could skin a cat a lot of different ways. And he actually wired one of his teacher's basements illegally while he's at Dunwoody so that he could get his passing grade in English. A nun once told my mom, she came home from a meeting of Bill, seventh grade, Catholic school. Now, we had this priest who was our protector, okay? His name was Don, but he was our protector. He made sure the Gormley boys didn't always stand the straight and narrow. In fact, I'll talk about that in a minute. But he always made sure that we were as well protected as we could be. So anyway, my mother goes to this meeting, and she comes home, and she said, Bill, boys, the nun told me that I shouldn't kill myself. What? What do you mean? She said, Mrs. Gormley, don't kill yourself. She was referring to Bill. This was in the days before special ed and all kinds of things. But everybody loved Bill, but he just didn't need to pass classes. But talking about being the protector. Rich, who's in California, who didn't come for this event, is a little guy. Now, I'm not very big. Bill was littler, and Rich is even smaller, but he had a mouth. Brother Rich had a mouth on him, and there were many weekend nights where Rich and Bill would come home later in the evening, Rich with a big smile on his face and Bill looking like he'd been in a couple of scrums, because Bill was Richard's protector. Kept him out of trouble most of the time, best as he could, and again, just the protector. And with that, I'm... Thank you.
Thank you. And saints of God now come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul now and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself, May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Again, Lord, receive his soul. Present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon him. Again, receive his soul and present him now to God the Most High. Again, I guess following our services, we'll be going next door. Okay. But let us join together in our closing song. Thank you.